UGD coming back at you with a H&K VP70 Z. That's right, guys. The first polymer pistol. Found this at a pawn shop. Yeah, it had been there a while, and I made an offer on it that, you know, it was pretty low, but man, they've had it long enough. They figured, what the heck? We'll give it to the used gun dude and see what he can make out of it. And guys, this is super cool in so many ways. It is the first polymer pistol designed and released in 1970. That's right. For all you Glocktards out there, Gaston did not come up with the polymer pistol. No, H&K came up with the polymer pistol, the VP, or the People's Pistol. It is really, really a cool example. And this one is super clean. Give you a quick rundown of this double-action Strikered 9mm hot rod. 8 inches long, pretty long gun, 5.5 inches tall, little over an inch wide. It's got, oh, you guys are going to love this. I keep trying to push that right there. That's a safety. Yeah, that's a trigger block safety, and I keep trying to hit that from a mag release. Nope, European heel release, and that mag doesn't drop out. But here's it is, 18-round capacity. Oh, drink that in. That is a beautiful magazine, and it's a unique magazine, and there's so many unique features. This is going to be a little bit of a longer video because I want to touch base on it. All right, let me get my blanks out of here. All right, here we go. We got to pull some dummy rounds out so you can see this. This is all rifle magazine, the Steyr GB top loading. Watch that. You just push down on the top. Yep, guys, no sliding in there. Just really a cool design. And 18 rounds. Guys, 1970 for a 9mm. I mean, that was unheard of. Of course, plastic was unheard of, too. Another unique thing is that trigger. Super cool trigger. They stole, I think, this back half of the gun from that Star Trek disc gun. I don't know if anybody remembers that. I'll try to find a photo and pop it up. But that trigger, look at this just ginormous trigger. And man, it needs it. This thing has got a long, heavy pull. Double action. This is ridiculous. Watch this. Oh, boom. Now watch the reset. I don't think I need to do that to reset it, but ready? Here we go. There it is. Yeah. Took that long to get the reset. Really a heavy trigger, and it is just not good at all. Now it's just really bad. That's definitely something that I'm sure when Gaston got a hold of this and he's designing his own, went, yeah, we're gonna do a little better there. Another unique feature, yeah, that's a rear notch, just like you know normally see. But look at that front blade, the big old piece of steel. And what they did was they machine a channel in it, and it gives the illusion of a post. Yeah, really kind of a unique sight picture. We'll see if we can make that work. Oh, it's just really glorious. And then the blowback design. Yeah, blowback design. It'll work, I think. I think it'll run. Probably a little less engineering involved there. But look at the rifling. I don't know if you can see that. The rifling on this is cut super deep. I'll get a really close shot of that. And what it does is it allows gas to actually get past the bullet and escape to lower the pressures on the gun. And, you know, man, I'm sure they got it to work. This model is early 80s. So, you know, it had been out for, you know, a decade. And I'm sure they had it pretty well perfected. But, yeah, I mean, this trigger is just ridiculous. I mean, it's ridiculous. And then a safety. Yeah. So, yeah, here's the rundown of the gun. It's one of those guns that it's the first polymer pistol. It's an important pistol. You know, is this, without this gun, how long would it have been before Gaston would have came up with the Glock? You know, you never know. So, all right, let's take this hot rod apart. Now, he definitely got this right. HK got this right. Watch this. Just take that. Bam. That's it. You know, a Glock, you got to fight that thing. Now, blowback design, just like a Jimenez for you Jimenez owners. Pull back, lift up, let that thing go. And let's start with the slide. Yeah, I've had it apart. I practiced this because I wanted to make sure I could do it right. But, oh, drink that gloriousness in. Oh, there it is. A striker. Yeah, a true striker fire. Big old honking West German spring. Oh, that is pure steel right there. And, oh, yeah, just check that out. Oh, the grip feels awesome on this thing. Wow, that is just a beefy piece of steel stuck in the plastic, both sides. Now, you guys know I love my barrels. I am a barrel connoisseur. Yeah, drink that rifling in. Holy cow. Yep, no ramp there. Yeah, yeah. I mean, that magazine, and I wanted to leave one in there just so you could see where this sits on this pistol when it's there. Look at that. I mean, it's just ready to go. It's just a beautiful gun. So, guys, there's your first look at a really unique and somewhat rare pistol. You don't see very many of them in the wild. I think right now on Gun Broker or on Arms List, there's one for sale. On Gun Broker, I think there's maybe a handful of these things for sale. And they're just so cool. So, guys, there it is, H&K VP70 Z. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up. If you thought, wow, he should have just stayed away, hit the thumbs down. And please, please subscribe.